guys, this is Jerry speaking. Welcome to LJPCBM React, episode number 586. Now, before we get in our LJPCBM Reacts episode, I want to react to T-Riffic Talks podcast and other things. Now, I wanted to say, I want to make an official announcement before we begin this LJPCBM episode. I'd like to announce that we need to push back some Bobshaw review reaction videos turned over time because I don't want to confuse you and everything, but I need to put reaction videos on Bobshaw reviews on hold until further notice because I need to get ready to clean up my Mac hard drive space. Number one. And number two, I just got done with, like 10 episodes of LJPCBM Reacts related to Bobshaw reviews. But in case of you wondering, no, I'm not gonna react to Bobshaw again until further notice because number one, it has to wait until number time, and two, I have to get ready to react to some things until further notice. So let's begin with T-Riffic Talks Podcast, Episode 4, begin in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Wow.
Can't hear. Like right now we're recording on December 5th and what you guys think of like Barney, BJ, and Big Bob's voices like reunited.
Wow.
It was like the most amazing thing. I can just feel like Barney is definitely coming back real soon. Speaking of Barney, we actually have a cosplay person who is Barney, the Grinch,
wow.
Donald Duck, and lots of more characters.
Wow.
I'm honored like to welcome my friend, Lucas Bradley. Lucas, how are you?
Well, I'm doing very well. Thank you so much for having me. And as of right now, I've already graduated college.
Wow.
I'm an adult now.
Oh, it's amazing that you're here. You actually like done like some like Barney on TikTok.
Yes, I have. In fact, just recently, I know we did the duets, which is the only way now you can find it is on my Facebook. And I just did a TikTok not too long ago. At the time of this recording, I did a TikTok with Barney singing the Imagine song from the Barney's Great Adventure movie, which was actually in Canada, Montreal to be exact.
Wow. Wow, I didn't know you were from Montreal. I thought you were from a different city of, thought you were from a different country or something. But anyway, continue on.
And, don't tell them where you live because they'll come for you.
I just gotta ask, we ask every person, like, who's been on T-Riffic Talks, how did you find Barney as, like, a kid or whatever?
Let's see. I grew up watching this show very, very young, and I loved the heck out of it. It was amazing. It was educational. It was actually no, I never grew up watching the show.
Really.
But yeah, I actually did watch the show until I was 4 because, believe it or not, Barney actually terrified me.
Really?
I'm not kidding.
Wow.
I'm gonna watch this saying like, he's gonna Barney. Why is this guy here? But yeah, as a kid, I did not grow up watching Barney at all because, I was just terrified of it. And yeah, as a kid, sometimes you have a bit of fear of people dressing in costumes, and yeah, it's normal when you're a kid. Right.
Okay.
But when I got older, I kind of began to feel more, how should I say this, positive about it. Mm-hmm. And I began to realize, Barney has become so well known over the years, and I always tell people that Barney shows love and compassion through the power of imagination. And I think that's what he's been doing. It is, and always will be. And I'm sure he's still doing it as of now.
Correct. Mm-hmm. And I understand, like, being fear of Barney. Like, when I was, like, I'll say four as well, I was terrified of Barney in the backyard game so much.
Wow. Wow. You're terrified of the backyard gang? Okay. Makes sense since I recently found this tape at eBay. Continue on.
The way how Barney was designed? No.
Yeah, because the thing is, though, when I think David Boss said that there was one, it's all like how Big Bird operated. Like, he had like a fake arm. One arm was operating one arm, and the other guy was operating it with a mouth. But then in some shots, we had to use both arms. They did have to use the bite jaw. And I heard that when you hugged him, it felt like sandpaper or something, right?
Yeah, wow. Like what Brian Epps said, like, it felt like sandpaper because it was really rough and just spray painted on.
It's coarse and rough and irritating, and it gets everywhere.
Yeah. Yeah, it's probably gets on your face as well.
Yeah. Mm. And for those who don't know the reference, it's Star Wars.
Wow.
A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away, Barney has come to save the Jedi's.
And it's amazing. Like, tell us like what you've been doing with your like your YouTube channel.
Which one, the main channel or the Game Review channel? Because keep in mind, if you want to talk about my main channel, I started YouTube at around 2008.
Wow, that was a year after I started YouTube. Continue on.
I've been on YouTube for over 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
At the time of recording, it'll be 2020, and by the time it gets uploaded, it'll be like close to like almost 13 years.
Wow.
Wow. Yeah, it's been past 14 for me. For such quote. Continue on.
I did my main channel. Basically, my main channel was more like personal stuff.
Wow.
Like stuff
okay.
I wanted to do stuff for personal reasons. I started off with school projects that I'd done in junior high school and high school, sometimes college. And then I posted the Grinch videos that I did, How the Grinch Leaked Smash Brothers. For those who don't know, it was based on the infamous Grinch leak that was posted around November or late 2018. When Smash Bros. Ultimate was just going to be released, and they were going to announce new upcoming fighters, as well as the Fighters Pass, which lets you play as more fighters.
Right.
And, spoiler alert, the Grinch League was a fake.
Oh, okay. Okay. No.
Yeah.
Thank God it was fake.
Yeah, thank goodness. Yeah, thank goodness for that, too.
Mm-hmm. And what can you tell us about, like, your gamer channel?
Okay, so the Fairly Odd Gamer channel. So before Fairly Odd Gamer, I did a commentary channel called VG Commentaries, which I did with a few friends. But due to controversy, we don't do any more videos for VG Commentaries anymore. But I want to do more gaming videos.
Wow.
So I thought, why not do game reviews? Originally, Fairly Odd Gamer was going to be like a Let's Play channel and then a game review afterwards. But I decided, you know what, let's make it a full-length game review channel.
Okay.
So, yeah, and so I want to talk about Hux Gamer for a moment, because Hux Gamer is pretty much one of the main stars of the channel.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so yeah, before Fairly Odd Gamer, I had Hux Gamer. So Hux Gamer is a neon green husky who likes to surf, enjoys surfing, lives in California, and used to sell surfboards at a local surf shop, and then he always likes to play video games.
Wow.
So he'd be something like, "How's it going, Duke? Glad to be part of this podcast, man."
Oh yeah, it seemed like in your Barney gamer video, and like he said, "How's it going, dudes? It's time for Barney says."
Yeah, well, that's what I wanted to do at the very end of. Yeah, because I remember at the end of every episode of Barney and Friends, they have this Barney Says where it pretty much just recaps everything that happened throughout the entire episode. So what I did was I thought maybe, I think it started back in season 3 where they had like, hey,
they have kids from like,
yeah, they had these kids. Hey, everyone, it's time for Barney Says. I wanted to do the same thing, but, I didn't have any kids to work with, so I just worked with Hux. That's all I did. And funny enough, I don't know if Brandon too is watching this. He probably might. Hi, Brandon, if you're watching. I actually took inspiration from one of his videos when he remade his Barney Says intro.
Wow.
And I kind of did my own take on it. So I want it to be based off like season one, season two, or season three, that kind of thing. So I just have him recap everything that happened in the video, and just have him say at the end, "And remember, I love you." So yeah, that's pretty much how it is. And the process of Hux Gamer was that I showed him the design. I did like 3 designs overall.
Wow.
And then I did like a 3rd design. I sent it over to a expert reference artist named Neon Slushy. Paid about $50 to get it done, and then try to find a good quality fursuit maker to make Hux Gamer. Hux Gamer, I designed the character. I'm letting someone else make the costume because I don't know how to make costumes.
Wow.
Professionally. And I found a fursuit maker named Lizard Love Mustache, or LLM.
Okay.
And I looked at her gallery of fursuits, and they looked incredible. How I found out about her was I was on Facebook one day, and I saw this fursuit of Reptar from the Rugrats.
Wow, okay.
She was selling it on eBay. I thought, oh, wow, that looks amazing. I think she'd be perfect. I want to know who made it. And I saw this little watermark on the bottom right of the photo.
Hang on. Turn it up so we can hear this. I can't hear a thing. Okay, let's continue on.
Lizard Loves Mustache. I looked it up, and it's a fursuit maker from Ohio.
Okay.
Wonderful designer. Her name is Lindsay Calvert.
Okay.
And she is amazingly talented. If you want to get a fursuit by her, I recommend her. She is amazing. If you plan on getting a fursuit, blend. But yeah, I sent her a quote. I sent her all the stuff needed. I had to make a duct tape dummy, which is basically like you just wrap yourself in like a black garbage bag and you wrap duct tape around your arms, your legs, sometimes your whole body if you're doing a full suit. But mine's a half suit, which is the head, the arms with the hands, and the feet with the legs.
Okay.
So yeah, I did a duct tape dummy of those parts to get like a better visual reference of what they're working with.
Yeah.
And it took around like 9 months to get Hux Gamer done.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And what I remember about it was I was going out of town to Seacrow Beach at a beach cabin. And I got a notification from Lindsay saying, "Hey, your fursuit's done. Pay me like $35 more for shipping." Which I did, and about 4 days later, it arrived, not while I was here, of course, but I was still in Seagrove, and thankfully we had a vet who had to take care of the cat. She actually took the box and mm-hmm. left it at the house. So once I got back from Seagrove,
mm-hmm.
I got the box and unboxed it and I put it on. It felt amazing.
Wow.
I had a debut at a convention called MomoCon, which is a anime gaming convention in Atlanta. You may be familiar with Dragon Con, which takes place during Labor Day. But
wow.
MomoCon takes much earlier. It's from Memorial Day weekend.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how Hux the Gamer was born. And the Fairly Odd Gamer, I started uploading on I started the channel on August of 2018, and I started doing uploads on September of 2018 with Finding Nemo. Did not do very well, unfortunately, which is why I think during like the 5th anniversary, which is not too far away, I mm-hmm. might go ahead and I might plan on re-reviewing it to see how I improved since then.
Mm-hmm.
And I understand that you have a Barney suit.
Yes, I do. In fact, before the podcast, I asked if I could bring my Barney suit, and you said yes. So, behold.
Wow.
To you.
Hiya, Green Bunny.
Hi, everyone. I'm so glad to see you.
Wow.
That is an amazing head.
Yeah, that was made by Desprostis Yasmin, who is from Lima, Peru. I actually do want to thank the person who built it. I apologize if I mispronounced her name. Gloria Teresa Huamani Horcaya, who is from Lima, Peru, and that's where I got the majority of my costumes from.
Wow.
From Donald Scrooge, Boots from Dora, Oogie Boogie. And that's pretty much it from what I can tell. I also have Solden from Monsters Inc., but I never used it for my project. I was gonna do a month of Monsters Inc., but that ultimately got canceled because it probably took too much of my time.
Yeah.
How did you get that suit? Like, did you have to show a design or?
No, in fact, Gloria actually had the suit made already. Like, I saw her gallery of, I saw her photos on Facebook, and she had a Barney suit made. I thought, oh, wow, that looks amazing. I should go get that. I think it was about $280 US dollars. She had to custom make it to my measurements. So, like, I sent her my measurements. I sent her my height. Again, like, I'm 6'2", meaning that I asked people who made the official costume, the official Barney suit, if I would fit in there. They said yes, because I'm around 6'1", 6'2". And, yeah, I would probably fit in that suit, like the official one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Because I got him, like, 5'11", and I'm close to like David Joyner's height, so if you add towels, then it'll make me a little more taller, like more carry if I wanted to.
Right. So like you might need. I think the best thing you do is like get some shoulder pads. Just get like more shoulders. Like I would recommend shoulder pads. Mm-hmm. Just get more of the Chewbacca
mm-hmm.
shoulders, which I think I would recommend. Yeah, if you want a taller with bigger shoulders, I would recommend getting shoulder pads.
Yeah.
And wow, it's like I would recommend it, and yeah, because like Barney's like a heavy suit, like up to 50 pounds.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I've heard from people who wore it that yes, it is very heavy, and I noticed that that they have like they have to support by the shoulders. I think like the way Big Bird did it.
Yeah.
Wow.
And I remember I watched videos of Adam Savage saying that he always says that like at Henson you never perform, you never work with a head because it causes so much strain on the performer, which is why they always have the costume on their shoulders, so that way mm-hmm. it gives more support and less strain on the head.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Would make plus they have to deal with a lot of stuff like heat, heat vents for the fans, moving the mouth, the voices, the kids, the directors. It's a lot.
Yeah.
Wow.
It obviously, I know it takes a long time, and I actually do want to show one more thing. I will. I actually wear a like inside the costume, inside the Barney suit that I own. If you put it on like this, you would they would see the face, like they would see the performer's face. Yeah, and I try to be as professional as possible. So what I use is like a faceless black spandex head mask that I wear over my head, so that way they can hide my face. So I can put on the suit without having to show the face at all.
Wow.
When you're doing it, do you wear it all the time?
Yes, I do. I wear it all the time.
For videos.
Yeah.
Yes, I do.
Okay. Because what I do, because like mostly I'm at home doing live streams or like doing like a sing along for YouTube. It's always
or Facebook.
Right, Facebook. And it's always like I always like I'm usually wearing like a t-shirt, shorts. Sometimes like I'm wearing winter silks, which the sweat will go into the shirt, not
in. Yeah, because I remember in a few episodes of the Purple Rose that yes, they do wear winter silk pajamas while wearing the official suits. For me,
which I've done reacting to Purple Rose before. Continue on.
T-shirts as well, and I also have like an ice vest that I wear to keep myself cool. And recently, I bought a white Under Armour shirt, which does, which same thing helps out. You don't feel the sweat as much, which kind of wicks in the heat.
It's probably like easier too, so it doesn't like break down the costume.
Exactly.
And I gotta ask, this year we had like amazing thing happened, like the Dana Park with Barney turned 25 this year.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
And as of now, Dana Park with Barney just shut down, unfortunately, because what I heard that Dana Park with Barney is completely torn down to pieces. And it was very sad to see them go. When I heard my childhood scene go, I spotted myself, oh my god, don't do this to us. But then all of a sudden, it did happen to us. And that's why I'm not going to Universal Orlando Resort having it ever again because of it. So, what I heard from the email from Barney Fan Club, this happened. So, there you go. Continue on.
How do you feel about that?
I mean, it's amazing. And I mentioned in the review that...
Oh, and by the way, before I let Lucas talk, I'm going to say this. I've been to Dana Park Barney once as a kid, as an adult. I'm only 24 when this happened. Getting close to be 23. Getting close to be 24 when this happened in June 2019, when I filmed the whole attraction. So I did that, the whole Mr. Pigaboo intro, and then the Barney thing, and then after that, it was the meet and greet. It was uploaded all over YouTube. With the kids, Bob suddenly just mess up with my copyright, but I did recover it, thank God, because it's all there to YouTube. So there you go. Continue on.
That the park's been around for over 20 years, and I think if I'm not mistaken, I think nowadays a Dana Park Barney is literally like the only place in America where you can actually see Barney live. If you have to see him on stage, you have to like fly cross country to like another country.
Yeah.
Just to see Barney live in concert. But
yeah. That I never wanted to go. The only place I'm gonna go is in English with Barney's A Day at the Park with Barney. I don't speak any language I'm sorry, so there you go in that. Continue on.
The one at Universal Studios is literally the only place in America where you can actually meet Barney live.
Right. a lot of like the other attractions are either in like mostly in international. Like mostly right now Barney is in Malaysia and Dubai.
Oh, I never heard of these places. No, never been there. And I don't never want to be in Barney places in these two countries. So that's no for me. These are poor countries. Continue on.
Right now.
Oh, yeah, isn't the Dubai costume, did that look not very good at all?
Okay, I know the story about what's wrong with the costume. Because apparently, the jaw broke.
Ooh.
And I'm not sure. Probably right now, they're probably like rebuilding a new costume.
Yeah. I think in Dubai, if you want to get like, you might want to get a costume that looks, that almost looks like the one from the show.
Mm-hmm. But mostly internationals, it's mostly like they make their own suit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because like, I think like the fleece is expensive.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Apparently because like Barney is really, like his fabric is really special. So that way it can like stretch.
Yeah.
And doesn't rip.
Yeah, I think recently I did have a small tiny rip like on the where the green belly with like it's pretty much on the lower portion of the body. I did like a simple needle and thread stitch and it works. It works really well.
Mm-hmm.
There are still a few wear and tear like with on the foam. I don't have a hot glue gun, which hopefully I can get mm-hmm. it fixed. But other than that, it still doesn't affect anything.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah. My old suit, it was ripping apart. Nobody can tell on the outside. But on the inside, yeah. So, and then what I did was like I'm hot glued and all that to make sure it looks good. Plus, no one could see it. The inside.
Yeah,
What's surprising, like in our suits, it inside is just all foam.
Mm-hmm.
Like no metal stuff or anything.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Mine is basically my Barney suit, the one I have is all foam. It's all foam, but covered in fleece. So yeah, it's the same material. It's the same materials that that we're using, and same material, but you know, the way it's designed is very different.
Yeah, especially Barney's mouth doesn't move.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, it could. I know I did it with you know, when I do the Barney streams with Brandon, because his costume is the same as mine, and it was made by the same person that made mine. So, what I would do, like I do the same thing that he did. Like I put his I just did like a moment ago. Like I put my whole arm, on the upper jaw because that was the only thing that would move, and that's what I did as a puppeteer. And speaking of puppets, I do have the genie puppet in the background.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
I have the genie puppet. I did it for a Brandon stream. I did it for a few cons, conventions. I did it for the Aladdin review, I try to do my best. Robin Williams. People say it's Will Smith, but I'm more familiar with Robin Williams. I've never seen
Robin Williams will be doing that. But Will Smith, okay. Continue on.
I have not seen the live action remake of Aladdin. Although I should.
I've seen it in theaters. Pretty good. Or Disney movie.
Yeah. I'm a huge Disney buff.
Mm-hmm. Me too.
Yeah, I'm a huge one as well.
I've seen a lot of stuff like Disney, like mostly like High School Musical, mostly like the Little Mermaid, Chicken Little.
The sky is falling.
Nemo, Cars, all of them.
Yeah, I'm glad you mentioned Finding Nemo. The movie was good. The game not so much.
You
played
Finding Dory?
I have seen Finding Dory, and that's actually pretty good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's really good.
Especially because, like, if it weren't for Ellen announcing it on her show, we wouldn't have known about it. Because
mm-hmm.
Ellen's been constantly asking, when are you going to Finding Nemo sequel? They finally answered.
Mm-hmm. And we got,
Wow.
When we're recording this, yesterday they premiered the 50th episode of Purple Roads, and they have...
Which I did a reaction video of it, by the way. Continue on.
We had Bob Lass, Julie Johnson, and Patty Wirtz. Barney, DJ, and Big Bob's voice. How did you feel about them?
Honestly, yes. Before anything, yes, I saw it. Is a classic among classics.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I remember, I think Julie mentioned during lunch break where she met with George Hearn, who played Grandpa. And of course, George Hearn, I knew he was in Sweeney Todd.
Yeah.
And
which I didn't know that.
And he had a
which I know it now. In the okay, I can't remember the 50th episode of Purple Rose, which I reacted to on LJPCBM. Continue on.
Fine, it said, say it. And of course, it's like, what was the line that said, at last, my arm is complete again. And then like bursting out laughter, I'm like, obviously they're huge musical theater fans. I mean, I know a lot about theater. When I said about college, I was I graduated with a bachelor's degree in theater,
mm-hmm.
so I know how to act.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I've done like theater work in like junior high school, college as well, and it's amazing like how I love being on stage.
Mm-hmm.
And also, I think when I became an actor, that's how I kind of lessened my fear of people dressing in costumes. Like these mascots do. I always think of them as just normal people just doing their job.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, but acting is the key. It's the key word for it. In order to be a good mascot performer, you have to be a good actor.
Yeah.
And, I'm not trained in pantomime. I have no mascot training. I like no professional mascot kids.
Yeah.
Although I feel like I should.
When I started Barney in the costume. No experience at all. I couldn't do the movements right. I couldn't move the mouth in a certain way how it looked like.
Right.
I couldn't make the head stay still.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Once
I'm
used to the environment in the suit and the entertainment, it's like, why are you doing this?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I feel like What I do is like I just watch YouTube videos. I just watch videos of it online. But I for all my costumes, I would just watch videos of people doing these costumes in the park, like how they pose, how they meet other people, how do they meet and greet with one another.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So I just watch these videos and
mm-hmm.
I'm like, okay. And also I do watch a bit of the movie to give me a few. Tips and ideas. And,
yeah.
And also for my videos, I also like to watch the original footage to give me an idea of what the choreography is.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the one thing I want to talk about is that for the choreography, sometimes I use the choreography from the show. Sometimes I just make up my own. I just wing it. I know some people that whenever they have a Barney costume, they just want to do the same choreography. The same choreography from the show, and I'm sure you do that as well.
Yeah,
but
when I'm in the suit, I try to like figure out who's movements that I want to try to do. Because sometimes I want to do David Joyner's movements or carries or some people from live shows as Barney or sometimes sometimes people don't know this some like moves I do, I make my own.
Of course.
Excuse me.
Yeah, basically, like the way we have our own suit, just do what you would do. Like I would just wing it. Just do your own choreography. If you're not familiar with it, just wing it.
Yeah.
That's what. Yeah. Yeah, that's what I do for my videos and, of course, for my TikTok, of course.
Wow.
Barney, if it's Barney's movements, it's okay.
Mm-hmm.
Like, of course.
You want to do a jump or a spin or aerial or bell kick.
Yeah.
You know, like how the safety of being in that suit.
Yeah, and here's the thing, though. The difference is that I was called... Yeah, if it's a costume that has, like, a head body attached, I with the feet separate, I know you say a one-piece, but I call it a two-piece because it's with the head and body attached. Mine is a three-piece, which means that the head and body are separated. And mm-hmm. people, I tell people that you are limited to what you do in the costume that mm-hmm. I have, meaning that you can't jump. I just lift my feet up and I just go on my mm-hmm. tiptoes to act like I'm jumping.
Wow.
And I actually tried once while jumping, and one time I did that, the head would pop off.
Wow.
So that's kind of the hard thing. So yeah, you're very limited. Depending on what Barney suit you have, bootleg or official costume, you have to be careful about what limitations you have.
Mm-hmm.
Like if it's a three-piece, you can't jump, you can't do like a... I can turn, but I can't do like a 360 jump.
Mm-hmm.
That's going to be very difficult.
Yeah.
But when you have a two-piece suit, you can do that easily.
Because mine, they're like the ankles are so spread, it could come off. So I
yeah.
be careful when I jump.
Yeah, I noticed that in some of your Facebook videos that when you jump, I do see the black socks that you wear. I think what I would do is that if you go do something like that, I would recommend getting socks that match the color of the costume. Like I would recommend getting like pink or purple socks.
Yeah.
For Scrooge McDuck and or Donald Duck. Yeah. For my duck costumes, when I tried them on, there are times where like it would. Or like I put on the pants and the ankles would show up like showing the skin. So what I did was I have yellow socks that I use to camouflage the my feet to camouflage the legs from the feet so that way you cannot tell.
Wow.
And those have worked for a long time, and I think that's why. The official Barney costume has like these ankle things, like it goes up to your lower knee, so yeah. that way if you do jump, they don't see skin showing the ankles.
It's
yeah.
easier, like it's attached to you, so that way it won't come off.
Yeah, and I think with my costume, it does. Yeah, my feet does have a thing where it does cover the ankles, so that way. That's the thing though. When getting a Barney suit, you have to be aware of what limitations you have. Like, what movements can you do or not do? Is it going to be skin showing? And is there any wear and tear? Just fix it as soon as possible. And I think you may have to figure out it.
And last year of October of 2019, we've heard the big announcement that Barney's coming back with a movie.
Wow.
I'm not feeling it, honestly. I personally, I've heard the movie was going to be very, very dark. I'm not buying it at all.
Execs have been saying, like, it's Mattel. They won't do that.
Yeah, I mean, I've heard what they're doing, and I hope they make it more positive as possible, or more light, because I think that's what the show is. It's very light, it's very meticulous, and you have, like, if you want to do a movie or a reboot based on the show, you gotta do it right.
Exactly.
Like, you know, I don't want to mention mobile references, but like, DuckTales, they did a reboot in 2017. And of course, now they just got announced that's being canceled after the third season, which is a bit of a shock, really.
Yeah.
I love the original. But yeah, But yeah, there are some, there are some movies based off TV shows that didn't really work out very well. The thing is, though, if you wanted to make a movie based on a TV show, you have to do lots of research.
Yeah.
You have to research everything. The story, episodes, anything. Everything. Mm-hmm. You have to come up with the right amount of research. And personally, if you were to ask me, I would probably go with a TV special rather than a full-length movie, because you're not wasting that much money on a full-length movie that might potentially not work.
Right. Especially mm-hmm. like the Lost Boys, what happened with Great Adventure was not good.
Wow.
The movie was actually going to be really good. And so, like, the director,
Steve Ballmer,
was like, yeah, it was like, not good. You don't have the budget for it.
Wow.
Yeah, I don't.
Good to, like, see the, like, that version of it.
Yeah, wow. At least they did something that they've never done before. They've been, like, be on location. It was filmed in Canada, and I know I talked about this before the podcast, but Deborah Brown, who was the choreographer, did shows for Cirque du Soleil, which I'm a huge Cirque fan, so I know.
Yeah.
And there are a few artists, that's what they're called, from Cirque du Soleil that actually got in the movie.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, right. I can recognize a few of these people that are from Cirque du Soleil, and who ended up being in the show, because Cirque du Soleil and Barney's Great Adventure, they're both from the Montreal, so that's how I know.
Okay,
but yeah, I know so much about movies. I don't know a lot about movies, but I know some about movies.
You got a favorite song of Barney?
Oh my gosh, there's so many. Of course, I do like the. I do like I Love You, but when I was a kid, I was like, oh, that song just annoys me. It's just, yeah, that's the thing, though. When you're a kid, sometimes when you don't grow up with Barney, you hear that song, it just somewhat annoys you. But I do understand why it has touched so many people over the years. I think that song alone is what kept Barney alive after so many generations. I do like Happy Dancing Feet because Filthy Keeps Away the Blues.
Wow.
Yeah, I know I did it twice, but I think there are so many songs that I have not heard yet, though I feel like I should.
There's a lot of good songs.
He has like a whole playlist full, and he just listens to them all day.
Mm-hmm. I have like a lot of albums I can listen to all the time. Before we end this, is there one word that you can describe Barney in general?
Wow.
I think, like I said before, Barney shows love and compassion through the power of imagination, and that's what he's been doing after all these years, and he's been keeping alive after all this time, and I think that's how it all, and that's what we all need. We don't need any negative things. We need to be more positive about ourselves, and I think that's what Barney has been doing, bringing more positivity in us, even though some people sometimes take it the wrong way.
Right. Especially right now in 2020.
During the ongoing pandemic.
Yeah. If some people say that, we need Barney now.
Absolutely. I think nowadays we need Barney more than ever.
Exactly.
He's still universal, but, you know.
Even like a special TV show.
Yeah, a big reunion. Like, not just from the TV show, but just like
big movie. Everybody.
Exactly. They need a bit of Barney in their lives.
Yeah. Probably mm-hmm. like the old cast.
Mm-hmm.
And also I want to give a big thanks to Kerry Stenson for actually doing that.
Wow.
If it weren't for him, without Purple Tales Podcast or even Purple Roads.
Yeah.
I don't know what would happen.
Exactly.
He probably would have died. So,
a big
hats off to Kerry Simpson for for showing us that Barney is just more than love. It's pretty much it's a part of everyone's life.
Barney's not just a character. I don't think of him as a character. I think of him as a friend.
Absolutely.
A friend that you always need and you can always count on.
Mm-hmm.
Or guardian.
Right.
A spiritual guardian, maybe.
And I'm so, like, thankful for Kerry to, like, he actually, last year, he got back into the suit.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, nice. But...
wow.
I wonder if he got back into the suit for the upcoming movie.
That was, like months before the movie was announced.
Wow.
Well, that makes so much sense.
Wow.
He returned with Kerry as well.
Of course, so... Which is sad for anyone that really wants Bob West to be back.
Mm-hmm.
He's a good voice. I like him.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think, speaking of voices, when I did Barney for the game review, I tried to do my best version of Bob West.
Yeah, which I need to have permission to react to Lucas's videos. If I wanted to, but that's just me. Continue on.
Yeah, I know yours is more deep, but
my voice range, you can really go to deep, so I always have to choose deep.
Yeah, and I've been a voice actor since 2014. So I've been doing it for almost 7 years now, which is by the time it gets uploaded, it'll probably be seven. So I try to do Bob West's version, though people have been saying on the comments saying that I sound like Dean Wynn more than Bob West. Well, I tried my best.
Before we end this, could you sing "I Love You" as Barney?
Sure thing. It'd be nice if we had the music on, but but even then, I'll do my best. I'll just drink some water for a bit.
Wow.
Alright, so.
Hi, everyone. Feel free to sing along to one of my favorite songs. I love you. You love me. We're a happy family with a great big hug and a kiss from me to you. Won't you say you love me too? Come on, everyone, sing along with us. I love you, you love me. We're best friends like friends should be. With a great big hug and a kiss from me to you. Won't you say you love me too? Wonderful singing, everyone.
Thank you so much for coming, Lucas.
My pleasure. And if you need me again, I will be more than happy to join you again.
That's great. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much for having me.
And thank you everyone for coming to Terrific Talks. I love you all, and I know that Barney loves you too.
And remember, I love you.
Did I sound better than myself?
See
you next week.
So that was T-Ribbit Talks Podcast, episode number 4. What do I think about this episode? It was amazing. Now I'm moving on to episode 5 and wrap up this episode with a huge bang. So let's do it now. Begin in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Bolton, and today we're going to be doing something a little different. Yeah, that's right. Today we're going to be having a story from your host, me. And we're going to hear some of my favorite stories I want to share with you. Before we do that, I have some questions from all of you fans of what you like sent to me, and I can't wait to read them. So the first one goes to Jake. Hi Jake, how you doing? Okay, it says, hi both. I have a question for both of them for his episode. What's your opinion about Barney the Backyard Gang that made a new series for it, which is called Barney and Friends, of course, and the feeling that TV series impacted so much while it was running, still running new episodes until 2010. On my opinion about the series, well, I actually love like how Barney Friends like could show like so much a lot of things, like more than Backyard Gang. Like they teach you how to be safe, how to use good manners, learning ABCs, playing games, learning how to use your imagination, and and of course, love. Hi, Barney. Good dear. Thanks for your question, Jake. Let's see. Our next question goes to Lucas. As you know, he was our guest from last week's episode. And his question is, what are some of your favorite episodes/videos of Barney and Friends? That's a good question. I guess I'll start with videos, because growing up, I really watched like various amount of like Barney and Friends home videos, mostly between like first and second generation of Barney. I only had like at least two videos like third generation, but by that time there was no fourth generation yet, so I can't say much about that. So I would probably have to go with my first one would have. I guess I'm gonna go like by order, like which generation probably like my favorite video is. So my favorite video for first gen was, I mostly grew up with Magical Musical Adventure, but my really top choice is Imagination Island, because I have so many memories like watching it. I sometimes like I dance to it at like probably like a young age, pretending like to be Barney. Speaking of Barney, you probably know I have a costume of Barney, and he's right next to me.
Oh. Wow.
There he is. Just standing there, wavering for like probably a live stream or like a Facebook live stream to go onto YouTube.
Wow.
Alright, my second generation home video, I would probably have to say, that's a tough one, because I had a lot of second gen, because I had Let's Play School, Sing and Dance, Round Round We Go, Barney's Beach Party, Walk Around the Block. Hard to tell. I would have to probably go with, oh, I also had Come On Over to Barney's House. So, yeah, I guess I'll go with Come On Over to Barney's House, because that was probably my first memory of, like, second generation. Third generation, Call for World. I had that on, like, a DVD, like, right when it came out. I just got the DVD right away.
Yeah.
At 4 years old. And I'll probably just have to go with, because I had Best Manners more, and I have like more memories with that video, so I'm probably have to go with that. Fourth generation, fourth generation didn't come out till the timeline when I stopped when I was a kid, like I stopped watching Barney like between like 6 to at least 9. Because, like, I was watching more, like, because, like, I didn't have, like, cable, and I couldn't watch, like PBS anymore, and it was, like, hard to watch. Well, and also, I'm from Canada, so we have, like, a treehouse, and Barney's, like, episodes come on there all the time, and I don't know why I stopped. Maybe, like, I just outgrew it for a little while, but, like, when, like, I started watching YouTube, like, around, like, 10, and I was, like, Googling, like, Barney one time, and then the first video I got was like a really old video of like a custom magical musical adventure intro, and I watched Barney probably since.
Wow.
Yeah, like, it was probably, yeah, it was like 10, like, yeah, 10. Then by 2011, I started my YouTube channel by then. Which is 2021 now, in July 15th, I think, will be my 10th anniversary of being on YouTube.
Congratulations to you. Continue on.
I'm not kidding. If you go to my YouTube channel right now, Bolton 2000, go to About, and you'll see how long since I've been on YouTube. It's amazing how long I lasted, right? So I would probably... To answer your question for like 4th gen, probably I would have to say probably have to go with I'll probably go with Let's Play Music, because it was good energy and the introduction to Riff and seeing what Mr. Knickerbocker actually looks like. Probably like the first home video Jen came out. Yeah, that's probably like my favorite video.
Yeah.
Thanks for sharing it, Lucas. Let me check if there's any other questions. This one goes to Donzel. This is not a question. He just said this. Frankly, I think Barney and French could last a longer, at least half as long as Sesame Street. Yeah, I think so too. I'm pretty sure it can probably last longer, because like, who cannot love this purple dinosaur? I mean,
yeah.
How can you hate something that loves you, and no matter what you do, he loves you forever?
Yeah.
Look at that. Look at that face. Thank you. I love you. I wonder if he can sing. Let me turn on the battery. Yeah. Oh no, I think he's dead.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go.
Okay.
How can you not love this purple dinosaur? He impacted so many children all over the world, like, so for so many years, and he's been around for like over 30 years.
Wow.
In 2 years, like, he's gonna be 35.
Whoosh. Yeah, exactly.
Thanks for your comment, Donzel. Well, there's not many questions. Wait, there might be more questions here. Let me just check. No.
Gotta think of something, but oh man. Gotta think of something.
Well, there's not maybe much questions left. So I'm probably just gonna like ask the questions I ask my guests, like, who come on every episode.
Oh well.
So I'm probably gonna say, how did I meet Barney for the first time? So that's a long story. I was born between season 6 to Super Singing Circus release, And,
yeah, okay. Born 2000, okay. I was born in 95, so there you go. I haven't met Barney until 2011, so in November, so there you go. Continue on.
I was in the hospital, so I'm pretty sure, like, when I was in the hospital, my mom was playing Barney when I was, like, with her on the television screen. Like, you know, like those big, white, like, big TVs, and they had the liquor wide back before there was, like, flat screens and all that.
Wow, okay.
Pretty sure, like, it was, like, shown, like, a season 6 episode, probably, by then, and then,
I don't know what it's called.
When I, like, aged a little more higher, I got, like, some, like, Barney toys.
Wow.
I owned, like, Silly Heads Barney. I owned, a Play School Barney.
Wow.
I had a lot of home videos. A lot than you can imagine. I still have to find the tape somewhere. I think, like, they're in the garage or something.
Over the rainbow, yeah.
I know it's
joking.
Somewhere. And, what else? Like, Barney's energy, just, like, his positivity, his love of characters.
Wow.
Just feel like it just impacted me so much. I just want to, like, I would say be with Barney forever.
And yeah.
I figure out a way how to. So what a better way was to do a YouTube channel. And as you know, like, my YouTube channel has changed a lot over the years. Because I want to show how much I love Barney in a really positive way. And what a better way was to do, like, to get, like, a costume.
Yeah. Okay.
This is one of them, and I had to learn from amazing people who played Barney in the costume and the voice. Like, I worked with, like, many, like, Barney voices, like, who are, like, oh, they're Barney fans as well. Like, I worked with, like, a fellow named Brandon, which you might know. He was a guest on the
Talks. If you had to check out a most recent LJPCBM episode on from episode 536, you know what I mean. Continue on.
He does, like, amazing Bob West voice. I love his Bob West voice. And his Dean, his Duncan.
Wow.
Tim. I'm surprised he can do Tim. Not many people can do Tim. What else? And, I'm talking about costumes right now. I'm gonna say this. I'm officially announcing that there will be a new costume of Barney.
Wow.
I'm gonna wear real soon. So keep an eye on my channel. Keep an eye on my social media posts, and you'll see the costume. Without a doubt, it's gonna be amazing. Oh. Gonna be so incredible to wear. Oh, man. Oh, and speaking of Barney, not last year because it's 2021 now. So
yeah.
2019. Yeah, October 2019. It was announced that Mattel Films and Daniel Kaluuya is gonna be producing a Barney movie. And how do I feel about that? Well, I'm not sure. It's hard to tell what you feel about the Barney movie. The one thing I really don't want to see in the Barney movie is to not ruin the character.
Exactly.
The franchise. Just keep Barney the way he is. You don't need to make him hip. You don't have to make him swear. Because, oh my god. Just keep him the way he is, sings his songs, keep singing I Love You, get the cast and crew on this production. Like, Well, I would, since like Bob like did Barney's Great Adventure, which was, I in my opinion about that movie, I liked it because I'm.
I love it as well, Bob Tom. But that's just me. Continue on.
Barney gave me like a positive attitude, so I felt like that movie is pretty good. Yeah, I would just say that. When I was a kid, I watched the movie, and I still love it since. It's pretty, even though like the ratings were pretty bad.
It's pretty bad, yeah.
It was okay with it. And the way how for the upcoming Barney movie, what I would really want to see is like the voices and probably like the bodies of Barney and BJ and Bebop Pop and Rick to come back.
Mm-hmm.
In some kind of way. I'm not sure about Barney's voice because, like, since Dean's the voice of Barney still.
Yeah.
And, the people really want Bob to come back, I would recommend that Dean plays Barney for the movie because. As Bob says, like, in interviews, he's not the current Barney, so I would really want, like, Dean to have his first theatrical film as Barney, because we see Bob did it, why not Dean?
Yeah.
And let me check if there's any other questions that I can answer. Let's see. Let me look at the comments. Okay. This one is from James D. Moore, 92. It says, I love Barney. I've been watching Barney ever since I was a little kid. What is Barney's favorite color? Well, as Barney once said, like he likes red, blue, yellow, green, purple, and whatever. All he can just say, he likes all colors because...
Colors all around the world.
there's more questions. Great.
All right.
This one goes to Rachel 7329. Tina was my favorite on Barney growing up. My favorite episode was the one about Bugs. I had that on VHS. Me and my sister loved watching it over and over. I loved Bugs and Spiders, and I thought it was awesome that Tina loved Bugs and Spiders as well. My favorite part was about the Spiders when they sang the Itsy Bitsy Spider, and then Tina was the Little Miss Muppet. Those were my two favorite nursery rhymes. I even had a spider puppet, like the one Michael had in the episode. Me and my sister loved this Itsy Bitsy Spider, and we took turns with crawling the puppet around and tickling each other with singing the song or pretending we were little Miss Puppet. And I just love that she likes spiders and bugs because I did that too at a young age, especially spiders. Wow, thanks for sharing, Rachel. That's like an amazing story. I love that.
Wow.
Okay, any other questions? Oh, yes. The creator, Barney, as you know, Cheryl Leach, she actually has an Instagram now, so
yeah,
you can probably like send her a message saying thank you for creating such an amazing character, and tell her they can probably let you see Barney as a kid. And maybe she'll probably get to be on Purple Roads.
Yeah, she got to be on Purple Roads. And that, folks, Why, right? I haven't followed her on Instagram yet, but I'll get a chance to try to, so why just be able to be in touch with Cheryl Leach where I get a chance. But okay, let's continue on.
Because, like, we're recording on January 18th, and,
Yeah, January 18th, and, yeah, I'm sorry, folks, but I'm recording this on March 9th, and I'm uploading on the 10th. Continue on. Yeah.
Oh, who's excited, like, for, because, like, Carrie is, like, getting a guest from Musical Castle, or could be from someone from the other tour, so it would be interesting. So might have Antoine, the body of Barney, or, like, some of the other diners, like, BJ Baydock's performers. I think, I can't remember their names.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I can't remember. Yeah, I guess that's what I have to share today. So thank you all for coming to T-Record Talks. I hope you had so much fun. I love you all, and Barney does too. You know what? Won't Barney say I love you one more time before we go? Oh, Barney.
I love you, you love me,
you're a happy family. Big hug. Just for me to you, won't you say you love me too? Can I have said it better myself, Barney? We'll see you next week. Bye.
So that was T River Talks Podcast, episode number 5. What do I think about this episode? It was amazing. So far, this episode went to be a success. Anyways, guys, that was episode of Ultra Reacts, episode number 586. Hope you enjoy it. Stay tuned for the next one, which is going to be episode 587. David Fowles versus the Money Cards, season 2, episode 19 through 30. Till next time, I'm Jessica. Goodbye. Peace out, baby. Good words to be added to guys very soon. Till then, Jefferson out. See ya.
This life I'll never take for granted, and given all the time I fail to really understand it, I never sought to meet the maker of reality, the one who gave the life that which is always happening. But I tried. Time I ask, I ask, why me? Why was I the one to see things as I do under the moonlight and the sun? Perception is the question, and the giver holds the key. But the only worth I've ever found was in melody. I still try.